Biostar are releasing a mini ITX motherboard for the X370 platform, as well as a B-rated version as well, which is the next one down from the X370. And basically, these are micro ITX motherboards. They seem to be the first people out of Gigabyte, ASRock and Asus to be able to produce a motherboard that's going to be supporting the Ryzen chip, which is going to be the flagship and obviously a micro ITX motherboard. So basically, I've done my research and I went to the Biostar website and I went to find out more information about this B-rated motherboard, which is the next one down from the X370. And I was checking for specifications and basically there wasn't really any. Well, there was, but it wasn't enough. And it does say subject to change as well with even out your notice. So if you go to the website and you have a look at the specification for the B-rated one, as well as the X370 micro ITX motherboard, it says right down to the bottom in red, caution, subject to change without your notice, basically. So things could be different. They could add a few things onto the motherboard and stuff like that. Who knows? So I have a Biostar motherboard right here, and you can see the kind of quality. This is the lowest sort of range. It's around about £60 that you can buy this for. And on the back, you've got DVI sub, VGA, and you've got your normal mouse and keyboard connectors, USB 3s, Ethernet port, and two USB 2s, and obviously your audio out. And then you've got four SATA connectors, 24-pin, dual RAM slots, and one slot for a graphics card. And basically, on that motherboard for the X370, it's got the graphics card slot is at the bottom with USB 3 on the side, and slightly few things that have changed on the actual motherboard itself. And I can't even remember if it comes with Wi-Fi or Bluetooth on the motherboard, but this motherboard wasn't too bad. It doesn't really, Biostar doesn't really have the ratings of like Asus, ASRock, and obviously Gigabyte. And obviously for overclocking, not too sure because this is not an overclocking motherboard. But the thing is that it's good that you've seen a micro ITX come into the platform from someone that is not a known brand, like that's really up there, like Asus, ASRock, and Gigabyte. So, and MSI as well. I forgot MSI. And obviously, being Biostar, it's really good that they've come a long way and they're actually trying to support the AMD platform as much as possible, and people that are wanting to support micro ITX motherboards and obviously micro cases. So after my last report about Nvidia's new graphics card coming to play within 2017-2018, it looks like it's been pushed even closer to the time of 2017, because Intel's going to be releasing their 12-core processor, and we know how that's going to be. That's going to be proper expensive, and if not, then it's obviously AMD have come along and they've kind of surprised Intel and Nvidia, and obviously with the price point and everything like that, and more cores, and gaming could change and everything like that. This is really, really quite cool. Anyway, that's all I've got to say today. So what are your speculations, or what have you heard? Leave it down in the comments down below, and I'll see you next one for some more news. Thanks for watching.